Kadaria, I mean, I think it's so right to have you on the show because
this time
where everybody is a journalist, everybody is saying something, you witness something, you record it, and you post it online, it goes viral, people get worried, and later on, I find out, oh, it was fake news.
Yes.
You know, how do we get back the trust? How do mainstream journalists get back the trust of the people where we trust and we know that, yes, the news we're getting from the mainstream media is accurate?
Okay, so there are two things. Over the last few days, I've actually spent a bit of time fighting on Twitter about people trying to sort of discredit journalism.
Right.
And people kind of believing that maybe we'll be going on the defensive and we're not recognizing some of the issues that we have. So we have to separate the two things. Journalism still matters.
Right.
It is a critical function that is required for any democratic country. If you choose not to be democratic, then you can do away with journalism. But if you say that you're a democratic country, then constitutionally, journalists are there because they're supposed to tell basically truth to power and hold people in positions of authority accountable.
Right.
So the issue of fake news, which is basically misinformation and disinformation, so disinformation being a deliberate attempt to mislead people. Misinformation is where you make mistakes, you know, because things have gone wrong. The fact that these two exist is not a reason for people to say do away with journalism. That is what tyrants want. You know, that is they don't want anybody holding them accountable. But do we have problems? Yes, we do. And it's not unique to Nigeria, unfortunately. We are in a misinformation and disinformation age globally. So as journalists, our job really is to follow process, is to put in place the things that we must do in order to ensure that whatever we take out to people is accurate, is credible. And where we make mistakes, to quickly own up.
Right.
I think trust is going to increasingly be a currency, and the media houses that cultivate and maintain the trust of audiences are the media houses that will do well. So again, it isn't saying that this isn't going on. It's about saying, how do we make sure that we improve our own standards?
I think you as a veteran owe certain people the opportunity of training.
Yes.
So these bloggers that we always group up and, you know, just discard, is there a possibility that, you know, the Institute of Journalism can offer them the opportunity to get properly trained so that we have, at least, because that platform is huge, we have
the
proper
thing is,
news.
Look, you can take a horse to water. You can't force a horse to drink. If someone decides they're opening a blog and
do
they
you
want
have
to
a platform
write and
that
it is open. Well, yes. So we've just opened our radio station, Radio Now 95.3. And part of the reason why we did that was that we thought the radio broadcast space has a gap. You know, we think Nigerians, we don't do the why, the context, the analysis. So what does it mean? How is it going to affect me? If I wanted to get engaged, what do I do? That sort of journalism is what we want to do. And part of what we're doing at the moment, there's a boot camp that is taking place where we've sort of made a call out for young journalists. 3,000 people applied.
Oh, wow.
I know. 50 were shortlisted.
Oh, okay.
And those 50 are now in the boot camp, and we're going to sort of work with them over the next few weeks, and then we'll sort of whittle it down to about 25 who will join us. And of those 25, about 15 will end up with full-time roles. And part of that is the recognition that people might have the talent, they might have the passion, but at the end of the day, journalism requires skill sets. And you have to teach people how to gather news, how to put it together, how to do it in a way that enables people to trust that process.